Hello everyone, welcome to One Life Investments YouTube channel, your one-stop shop for beginner-friendly crypto content, guides, and latest alpha on different altcoins. In this video, I'll guide you on how to load funds to Optimism, to use dApps that have been deployed on Optimism mainnet. So let's get started. Before jumping into the video, a quick disclaimer that I'm not a financial advisor and you should not take anything that is mentioned in this video or any other videos on this channel as a financial advice. I suggest you and encourage everyone to do their own research and due diligence before investing or using any protocols or services. Just a quick side note that I will not be confirming any transactions, but you can follow along and I guarantee that at the end of the video, you will understand on how to bridge your assets or how to send funds to your Optimism wallet via different routes, right? So there's two ways to load funds to Optimism. One is if you have a dedicated self-custody wallet, for example, MetaMask, Trust Wallet, or any other wallet, and you have funds on it, for example, Ethereum or any other funds, and you want to send those funds to Optimism, right? Now, what I suggest is you do not bridge any other asset except Ethereum, because once you bridge to use the dApps, you have to pay gas fee for the transactions, and that gas fee is paid using Ethereum. Now, if you bridge any other assets, unfortunately, there is no faucet at the moment, at least the one that I'm aware of, for Optimism to get some test funds, and you'll have to bridge some ETH again, and you will be bridging twice. So bridge ETH and then carry out transactions or convert that ETH to other asset that you prefer once you are on Optimism, right? So first, let me show you the official bridge and how that works. Now, if you are not aware that there is a rumor of Optimism airdrop, if you'd like to watch a dedicated video on that, then watch that video on the top right corner or on our channel. But for the purpose of this video, I'll keep it short, right? So go to app.optimism.io/bridge. I'll make sure that all the links to the website and tools will be in the description as always. Once you go there, you go to the deposit tab. There's two tabs, deposit and withdraw. I'll have a withdrawal video in the future, so you make sure you subscribe so that you don't miss out on that. What you do is you connect your wallet first. As you can see, my wallet is connected and it's connected to Ethereum mainnet. It doesn't really matter. It has to be connected to the Ethereum mainnet because the bridge by default thinks that you are bridging from Ethereum mainnet layer 1 to Optimism layer 2, right? So if you want to do that, you select Ethereum mainnet and you are sending ETH to Optimism. You could select, for example, I want to send 0.01 ETH, and then you deposit, and then once the deposit goes through, it usually takes around 5 minutes and you'll have your ETH on Optimism for you to use different dApps on it. Now, what if you have your assets on other networks, for example, not on Ethereum, but on Polygon, Binance Smart Chain, or even Arbitrum? What do you do in that case? So if, for example, you can go and select, for example, if you have some assets on Polygon, and as you can see, you have options to choose from Hop Protocol, Synapsis Protocol, Stellar Bridge. And if you have assets on Binance Smart Chain, then you can use the same. And if you have assets on Arbitrum, you can still use all of them. So if you want to watch my dedicated video on Hop Protocol as well, that video will be in the top right corner as I speak now. And what I will do now is I'll just go over quickly on how you can use a Stellar Bridge to send funds, right? So how to send assets from other networks to Optimism, for example, Binance Smart Chain, Matic, Polygon, etc. So Stellar Bridge, you go connect your wallet, MetaMask. Once connected, you select your source chain. For example, in my case, it is BNB, let's just say. It will ask me to connect that as well. That's fine. Switch network, because I'm going from BNB chain to Optimism. Going to BNB to Optimism. What I can send is Binance pegged Ethereum token. So now this is pegged. This is wrapped, right? So I'm not sure how comfortable you are, but you can just send how much you like. I probably don't have anything, so it's not showing anything. But you select, you enter the amount of Ethereum you want to send from BNB to Optimism, and then you hit transfer, and then you confirm your transaction in your wallet, and that's all, right? So that's how you can bridge from other networks to Optimism. Now, the second scenario, if you have some assets on, let's say, Binance, you have some assets on Bybit, KuCoin, Huobi, and other centralized exchanges, you can use those centralized exchanges to fund your Optimism wallet. For example, if you go to the ecosystem page and select on Ramp, All right, so as you can see, we have five different options on Ramp. Two of the popular ones are Huobi or KuCoin. So what you can basically do is from Huobi and KuCoin, you can withdraw directly to Optimism. Now, please bear in mind that sometimes these services are not available. In that case, you will have to use some bridges, but I'll go into detail on what to do in just a second if these options are not available. So if you go to KuCoin, you go to withdraw crypto from KuCoin. So select your asset, for example, ETH in our case. You paste your address, you select your network, so select Optimism. As you can see, it's not available at the moment, but Arbitrum is. So Optimism, if it is available, select Optimism, select the amount of ETH you want to withdraw, and confirm. So that's how you withdraw. Same process for Huobi as well. All you got to do is when you are trying to withdraw crypto, instead of withdrawing it to anything else, you withdraw it to Optimism. So what to do if you have, if Huobi, KuCoin, or decentralized exchanges are not currently supporting Optimism. So if you go to Bridge, there is a bridge called LayerSwap. So I'll have a dedicated video on how to use LayerSwap, where you can use LayerSwap to fund your Optimism wallet from a lot of different exchanges, for example, Bittrex, Kraken, CDC, Huobi, KuCoin, OKX, and a bunch of others as well. So you can use these centralized exchanges to send asset to Optimism. At the moment, it only supports ETH or USDC, but it doesn't really matter because we are trying to send USDC, and it's actually very cheap. For example, if I send one ETH, all I got to pay is 0.005332 ETH. Why this is the case is because the transactions are happening centrally, right? There's no AMM, there's no DEX involved in between. This is all done centralized in a centralized way, and LayerSwap takes a tiny fee or tiny cut to fund your wallet, which is actually very efficient. In the past, you weren't able to fund more than 0.1, something like that, but now the limit is one ETH, so you can use LayerSwap to fund your Optimism as well. I'll have a dedicated video on LayerSwap because there is rumors that there might be an airdrop in the future. So if you'd like me to create an airdrop video for that, please like the video. And I hope this video was helpful. If you still have any questions, please reach out to me on Twitter, One Life Investment, or just leave them in the comments below as I try to reply to each and one of your comments. And if you have any suggestions as well, leave them in the comments as well. And I'll see you in the next video. Thank you, and you have a nice day. Please check out other videos from One Life Investment on your left or right, and subscribe using the button in the center. Make sure you always do your own research and never invest than what you can afford to lose.